Hey peeps, want to know how we continuously monitor for web performance and accessibility? Well, Daniel and Deepak, they're going to show us how the Azure Cloud Collaboration Center does it on the next episode of the DevOps Lab. Hi, and welcome to the DevOps Lab. DevOps is all about continuously delivering value. And just because our code is in production, it doesn't mean we're done, because we still need to know things like, is our app up or down, or is our app performing well, or is our app accessible, right? So things like that absolutely affect value. Well, today we've got some special guests. We've got Daniel and Deepak with us, and they're both from the Azure Cloud Collaboration Center. And they're gonna be showing us how they monitor web apps for performance and accessibility. Hey, Daniel and Deepak, how's it going?
Hi, how are you? Thank you for having us.
Yeah, so tell me a little bit about yourselves and what you guys do at Microsoft.
Yeah, so I'm Deepak Seni. I'm a developer in Azure, in Azure Cloud Collaboration Center team. And we deal with a lot of web applications and web pages and dealing with the performance, accessibility, and what all that comes with it. So I'm happy to be here on this show.
Yeah, great to have you back.
Thank you. And I'm Daniel Lopez. I'm part of Azure Cloud Collaboration Center as well. I'm working under Deepak. This is my second year now, and I've been working a lot of cool stuff, some accessibility and some performance stuff. So I'm here to show you all that today.
Very cool. Well, I'm so glad you guys are here to tell us a little bit about how you guys do performance monitoring and accessibility, right? So why don't we just jump in? Tell me what you got.
Sure. I'll start. So I'll give a little bit of context and the value of some of the things around the performance monitoring and accessibility monitoring we have done. So as you know, the monitoring of web page performance metrics is more than most developers realize, right? As for our users, attention spans are getting shorter and not longer, right? Customers make snap judgments about it. Application of web page experience. So we don't want to let the first thing they see is a big, slow loading, blurry logo, right? So web page performance is a critical factor in user experience and hence user retention. So putting in perspective, right, pages that load within 2 seconds have an average bounce rate of 9%, while pages that load in 5 seconds see their bounce rate skyrocket to 38%. Wow. So even a 1 second difference in loading time can have a huge impact on the performance. Mm-hmm. So on the same lines, right, there is performance is also sort of twofold when you go deeper and try to improve it or monitor it. Is there is a notion of perceived performance, and then there is an actual metrics which you collect, right, in terms of how much time the page load is and so on and so forth. So, but perceived one is more like when it is ready for interaction, right? Or when users can consume it in the way they want. So it's very important to also look at not only from the metrics which you traditionally used to, but also the perceived metrics like time to interact, right? Or what is the contextual pain time, right? And what is the interactive load time? So all those things are very important. So that is about more what is sort of like importance of performances, right? And there is another topic related to that in some way and very common in context of web application is accessibility. You want your application to be accessible to more users and cover the scenarios that all the users which you intend to reach, they can access it in the most optimal way as you want them to. So accessibility is forefront of application development these days to make accessible to more users, right? So with these two sort of things in mind, we basically, if you think about it, right, there is an aspect of how do you identify these metrics, right, or these issues in your application, and what do you do to take action? So we are focusing more on the identification or discovery of those, because once you know the problem, it is easier to solve, right? But most of our energy, time and energy goes into where is the problem is, right? And it has to be, it is more efficient to be knowing proactively than your users or after it goes into prediction, you came to know. So that's the whole point, right? So what we did basically is, and that's where coming into this context of Azure DevOps and with Abel with us, just to emphasize that, how did we leverage Azure DevOps pipeline to kind of our journey of implementing this whole notion of continuous performance monitoring and accessibility is what we're going to share with you all today. And just to give an idea, right, the high level architecture is like we have a pipeline, CI/CD pipeline, as most of you have for our cloud applications, right, using Azure DevOps pipeline. So in the pipeline, we have the build happening, and then I'm talking at a very high level, right? There are other associated things, but build happens, and then we deploy in the test or pre-production environment. And that's where we run this tool for performance measurement called Lighthouse. It's an open source library from Google Chrome team that we are leveraging. And basically, it gives you all kind of very interesting metrics, both in the category of perceived performance as well as the real performance of your web page, right? So we run it as, and then we report it, the output of it, in two ways. One is we log into application insight so that we can do rich analytics after the fact on how the performance of web pages were. And also within the DevOps, we kind of show the results in the custom tab, right, for performance that we customize. And that's another aspect and the beauty of Azure DevOps, that it gives you the platform to show the results of whatever the task you did in the pipeline. So we do that. And then, so from the reporting perspective, that's a thing. And another important aspect is, it's worth mentioning, is say we deploy in the pre-production and then we run these tests for performance. And we found out that, for example, our threshold or our standard is we do want this page to be load under 2 seconds. And in that deployment or that release, it took, say, 3.5 seconds. So not only we are reporting that, we are stopping the build or release rather to go into the production and get the incident or notification to our development team and say, here is the identification of the issue. And then we can take a corrective action from there. So that's an aspect of, that's also the one of the feature in Azure DevOps pipeline where you can stop it to continue on error or whatever the notification mechanism we have. Mm-hmm. So that's about the performance monitor, right, at a high level. So same approach and pretty much the same infrastructure of implementation we applied beyond performance to accessibility. And this time we use a different tool. It's called Xcore, but on the same lines, right? And to mark out any accessibility in compliance and then take a corrective action. So the focus is to identify those and stop the pipeline from releasing further, whatever your gates are, and get the rich reporting out of it.
Wow, so that sounds really cool. So you guys have literally built in pipelines that will take your code so I can check in my code and that's just gonna build my app and then send it into like maybe a staging environment. And then you'll start running tests. And then based off of those tests, you're going to tell me performance metrics and accessibility metrics. And if it passes thresholds, you'll just stop it?
Yeah,
exactly.
Oh, my goodness. All right. That sounds crazy cool. I kind of want to see this in action.
Let me show you. Okay.
Okay.
So this is my part. So Deepak explained a little bit of what Lighthouse is. It's an automated tool for auditing a web page. So you'll give it a URL. It'll run a series of tests on it based on different categories. So it has performance, best practices, accessibility, many different categories. And for each category, it also has specific metrics. So this is performance here. You can see that it has first contentful paint, speed index, time to interactive, first meaningful paint, some of the metrics that we were mentioning. And it has a description of what it stands for. So for example, FMP, is the one that we use, and it measures when the primary content of the page is visible. This report also has screenshots of the run, it has details of why it failed, it has a link to learn more, and it'll basically explain why it failed, why it's important, and what you can do to fix it. So to kind of show you what this looks like in the pipeline is, it's really hard to keep tabs on this as an engineer. So let's say I checked in some new code and those updates might have performance regressions or an accessibility violation. So this is a pull request that I made with new code, and you can see that it failed. I want to see more details on this, and it'll open up the failure. You can see the exact jobs that it was running, and it first installs some stuff. You can see here that we have a deployment. So it deploys the updates or the changes to a URL, like a staging environment that Abel mentioned. And then once it's there, we can run a series of tests on the actual URL. So here, it ran it on this specific URL up here, channel 99 sample app URL. Mm-hmm. And this is the app here. You can see that my changes broke this button. You cannot really read what the fail says. If someone has some color disability of vision or something like that, they won't be able to read this. So that's one violation here for, so this one is Lighthouse. This is the FMP violation. So you can see that the home page failed with an FMP score of 0.21 when our threshold for this one was 0.001. I set a very low threshold here just so I could cause it to fail. Mm-hmm. And you can see the Axe scan for accessibility also failed. This one tells you at home, we had one violation. It tells you the exact violation. It's a color contrast, and basically with the foreground and background not meeting those contrast ratios that are required, it gets better. So from here, you can see that pipeline published some results. You can see the Lighthouse results, for example, here. You download it, and it'll open a report, an HTML report. So it'll show you the exact details. Here you can see that this is a 0.2 score that we got and it failed. All the screenshots, all the details, all the good stuff. So from here, you can also check out in the scans tab, a details on the accessibility test. And it'll tell you exactly the location, the exact button of why it failed. So you can see that it says it's the fail button, which is the one I showed here. So now we can pinpoint it, we could go back in the code, fix it, resubmit and update this pull request, have it succeed, and then we can merge it with master and release it to production. So it's a lot safer, a lot quicker. We don't have to wait for the metrics to report to prevent regressions. It makes my life a lot easier, and I think everyone else's too. So I highly encourage doing something like this. I have created a sample project here where you can actually see all the code for yourself. You can see how we run the node modules, Lighthouse for Axe Core as well, and some basic details. It's a very simple app, and you can go check it out. It's public, and it'll be down with the details of the video. So that's pretty much it, and you could do a lot of cool stuff from here. If you would like these results, you could also log them with the logger of choice and have those be visualized in other dashboards or other cool places as well. So this is pretty much some of the tools that we decided to use. You can use, there are some other tools for running basically performance and accessibility testing, but we actually decided to do basically Lighthouse because it uses common web perf metrics. So it uses FMP, FCP, a lot of the metrics that we showed, mm-hmm. and those metrics are common across the web, so you can pretty much find them anywhere and find consensus around them. Since it gives you a score, it's easy to define thresholds on which it failed. And it has all the good, rich information of why it failed. Axe Core, we decided to use it because it's basically the base, the foundation of every accessibility tool out there. So most tools out there that test for accessibility are actually built on Axe Core. And Axe Core gives you all the extra information, a superset of all the information. So we decided to use that directly and filter for all the evaluations that we think are important for our specific app, for our needs. So With that said, I would like to hand it back here to you, Abe. Thank you so much for having us. This is awesome. Do you have any questions?
Yeah, so if my viewers are interested to like test this out and stuff, we have links down below that they can try. You're going to share your repo and stuff. So I just want to make sure the Axe Core and also Lighthouse, these are open source tools, right, that anybody can just use?
Correct. Yes, they're open source, and you can see the code, contribute if you'd like. They're open. They're out there.
Man, this is so crazy cool, guys. Thank you both for coming up here and sharing this with us. I get people asking me all the time, how does Microsoft do things, right? So to have you two kind of walk us through how we do things, that is freaking awesome. Thank you so much. Now, again, if you want more information on how the Azure Cloud Collaboration Center does things, check out those links down below and join us next time on the DevOps Lab.